Howdy folks, and welcome back to Derping and DIDDO. It's been a while, but I have kind of had an itch to play lately, so we're going to get some play in. If I recall correctly, we had just finished the Catacombs quest line, and being about level 6, I would say we are ready for the Assault on Splinterskull quest line, which is substantially longer. I think the Catacombs quest line is like 5? No, according to DIDDO, we get is 8. Alright, so Splinterskull is not that much longer. Quest number-wise, Splinterskull's only 10. But Assault on Splinterskull has much, I guess, larger quests. Although, they basically all take place in two areas and you just run through them like a half dozen times. Because raisins, I don't know. So, I remember nothing. It's been a while. This is the first time I've really booted up DIDDO. Since I stopped recording because they just keep releasing patches and breaking things and it's just the way it is. It's DIDDO and the audio seems a little quiet. What bit of a 75 here? How's this? I'm gonna give me some sound effects. Yeah, that's better, I think. Anyways, yeah. So we're back. There's a new update. I don't want to say soon, but there's a new one coming with some class revamps and stuff. And they're releasing more cool dungeons. They've been releasing remakes of old adventure modules, and I have been just loving the shit out of it because it's first and second edition stuff, and that's the stuff I grew up playing. So it immediately twangs the, oh my god, I remember playing through this when I was like 8, and I must see it now. So that's coming, and there's talks on the forums. The developers have mentioned that there's a possible expansion planned for next year. The end of 2017, I believe they said. Possibly. That excites me. So I'm hopeful. I'm hopeful that things are kind of gonna, you know, turn around a little bit. They're working really hard on a revamp for the crafting system, I guess. They've been previewing it, and I'm okay with what I'm seeing. We're still gonna be missing some properties on stuff that I wish we had. Like body feeding, I think, is still gonna be gone, and the game has possibly locked up because there it goes. Because DIDDO, as you guys can see, the performance is still, you know, absolutely amazing. Look at that. Look at that. What causes that? Turbine, fix your shit. Oh my lord. Or no, it's not yippers popping in, but. Yeah, and I'm recording this. It is what time is it? It is early in the morning right now. It is 3:30 in the morning, and you know the server population is probably like 30 people. Well, it's more than 30 people. It's not a lot of people though. I don't suppose you can. It won't give you a count, sadly. This is House Deneath. I do not want to go to House Deneath. We are going to House Farallon. And then we're going to have to go through, what's it called? I want to say Tangle Root, but it's not Tangle Root, I don't think. Oh, it might be Tangle Root. I can't remember. What's it called? I think Tangle Root might be WoW. No, it is Tangle Root, ha! Huh. Then what am I thinking of in World of Warcraft? The damn jungle zone that everybody ganks people in. How can I forget that? I don't know, but I'm sure someone will let me know in the comments. I'm not worried. Anyways, this quest line goes from 3rd to 7th level, so the first, I don't know, 3 or 4 quests are probably going to be kind of face roll difficulty. Oh my god, I'm going to have to get used to the controls again. The first couple quests are going to be face roll difficulty, but the latter part should be fairly challenging. Alright, I believe. Greetings, friend. Might I interest you to transport to Tranglefoot Gorge? Yes. Excellent. I will take you to the One-Eared Bugbear. It's the inn closest to the gorge. Be sure to speak with Aramek Qual in the tavern. He knows Tanglefoot better than anyone. I have a feeling I know it better than he does. At least the parts we'll need to go through. Hey, and there's somebody here. Pale Master, if I had to guess, because he's got his little skeletal minion that's, from what I understand, quite useless. Hey, Aramek. If you're looking for work in Tangle Root, Urgers is the one to seek. Ungers? Who's that? It's a hobgoblin boss of some sort, from Dargoon across the sea. I've been having trouble with the local tribe. Splinterskull, they're called. He mentioned he wants outside help. Alright, where do I find him? There's an old ruined keep across the gorge itself. It glows blue at night. People say it's haunted, but it's really just how Ungers keeps Splinterskull from rooting around in his hideout. Look for him there. Except in reality, I'm a dog, so that encounter was more like grr, arg, and he's like, what? Grr, 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 go outside, you flea-bitten mange creature. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and bind our soul here so that if I end up dying... And look at that beautiful code there, some string table errors. We are approximately 5 minutes in, and Turbine's shoddy coding is already showing. I don't know why they don't fix that. It's a reference error to a string of text on a table somewhere. It's not hard to fix. They're just being lazy asses about it. People have lists on the forums of these things. They just need to go in and change, like, a number of reference, and that's it.
The one-eared bugbear in ale, lodging, and transport to Stormreach within.
And, like, I'm not even talking out of my ass. I do programming. I know how this shit works. They're just being lazy. Fuck. Ugh. If it's not just a single pointer reference like that, then it was incompetently programmed. Lord. Alright, and the reason we're coming up over this way is there's an optional that occasionally spawns here. I don't know if he is. But there is a rare wolf that will spawn up here. Which it doesn't look like he did because I'm not seeing any loot. Chest.
The grim remains of the
nah. Damn.
Whose felled corpse rests trophy-like in the wolf den.
That's okay. Random skull. This is actually a wilderness area, which we don't really have too much, but as you can see, we got Slayer, Rare Encounters, and Explore. This is honestly, if I had to put money on it, probably one of the least explored explorer areas in the game. I can think of maybe one or two others that people avoid more than this one, but most people don't poke around here. They just go and do this quest line and they're done. And I can't say I blame them. This came out, I honestly don't remember whether or not the game shipped with this. I want to say it did, but I remember everybody avoided it. I don't remember why, because I mean, it's just hobgoblins and stuff. I mean, there are some nasty things out here. Like, if I recall correctly, there's a rare encounter you can have with a hill giant that's pretty, you know, if you're here in level appropriate times, you know, robust bracers, robust. Yeah, this is another thing that they, air quotes, fixed. They have the value, so this is robust, whatever robust does, plus two bracers of spell sight, which is spellcraft, plus seven. And they just have two and seven, which, lazy, lazy, lazy. They just throw the value of it in there. So, plus two poison resistance and plus seven spell sight. Wait, seriously? Wait, seriously? No, put my spearbane bracers, where are they? Plus seven competence bonus to spell sight. Oh my god! That's spellcraft, if I recall correctly. Yeah, oh my lord. I don't even know, guys. I don't even know. Like, fuck. Everybody's like, game's in maintenance mode, you guys. Quit paying for it. And I'm like, no. And the more time goes on, the truer it seems. But they did just release a bug fix patch today. Actually, so that counts for something. I mean, they only fixed like half a dozen bugs, but that's better than the none that they've been doing. So I'll take it. You know, some bug fix is better than no bug fix. And we want to go to start this quest line, actually the opposite direction that we want to go and that we're going now. I'm just kind of wandering because I'm talking and that's what I tend to do. Oh no! Fuck. Oh, okay. All right, we're okay. I was worried for a second there. That could have ended poorly. I gotta remember. I have to remember that Q and E, I can't use them to strafe in this. Sadly. Okay, and also, speaking of which, I might as well pimp my blog. GhostLPs.com. I have an article on there. Any of you guys looking to start up in this? Yeah, got a little quick start thing in there that kind of explains things a little bit, how the game functions and whatnot. So you might want to poke around at that. I'm working on a quick build guide. It'll give you a character that from first level cap will be able to solo pretty much all of the non-raid content in the game. It's essentially the character that I play as my main, but probably a little bit more effective because my main has been cobbled together over you know, however many years. In the long term in this, you're supposed to hit level 30 or whatever, and then reincarnate and go back to first level and then do it all again, and you get little bonuses for it. I've never done that. So I've had the same character since the same main character since I started playing this game, and I have not reincarnated him or anything. But that's just the way of things. I don't know. I don't like leveling my characters again. What is that? There's a cave down there. I think that's full of troglodytes, if I recall correctly. I do not remember. Regardless, we're eating some bugbears, because that's what we do. We eat things, because we're a dog. I still haven't put any work into, well, I shouldn't say I haven't put any work into long-term planning for this character. I think I have a pretty good idea of what we're gonna do. Oh my god, I've come to another.
Half overwhelmed by the jungle. The scratches and stains around it say bugbears dwell here.
I took a right when I should have took a left, because, again, I was talking and not paying attention. See, this looks like something's going to smash its way out of there to beat the shit out of me if I'm not careful, so keep my eyes open. Bugbear land is not for city dwellers. Yeah, well, sucks for you. Anyways, my long-term plans, instead of, I was thinking about multi-classing. I know a lot of people multi-class. When you're playing an offensive caster, they multi-class like 2 or 4 levels of sorcerer. Yeah, I saw that coming. They multi-class 2 or 4 levels of sorcerer. And the reason you do that is because sorcerers, or not sorcerers, favored soul, rather. And the reason people do that is favored souls get a skill tree called Angel of Vengeance. Hey, we got a chest. Oh, there's a rare in here. I don't think I've ever fought this guy before. I mean, he's kind of like, at this point in the game, nothing to us. I'm going to just destroy him as Yipper stands there looking busy. Yeah, I'm okay with that. Yeah, never fought this guy before. Cool. Nifty. We got some loot. Anyways, a lot of people take favorite soul levels for Angel of Vengeance because it gives you bonuses to elemental damage, fire damage specifically, and I assume you would just use produce flame a lot. I can't remember whether or not druids get flame strike. If they do, that would also be something to use it on. The downside though is if you really want to get the most out of the benefits that the Angel of Vengeance tree gives you, you've got to go like 4 levels into favored soul, and that means trading off 9th level druid spells, which were I playing like I normally do, I'd be like, I don't give a shit, whatever. But since I'm specifically playing an offensive caster, I want to have 9th level spells on Druid particular because it gets us Earthquake, which from what I understand is incredibly powerful. Whether or not it actually is, I do not know. Yippers, all right, you are with me. I'm still used to Knights of the Old Republic where the AI companions lollygag and, you know, you'll be at a dungeon entrance and they'll be back in town wondering where you went because their AI don't think so good. All right, oh, that's right. I totally forgot about this. I bought that damn wand of Cure Critical Wounds. I can't even use it yet. By the time we're done with this quest line, we'll probably be 7th level if I had to guess. I am certainly not going to do it all in one go here. We're probably gonna be able to hammer out, assuming I go for like 30 minutes, which if I recall correctly is about where I was going for this series. We'll probably be able to hammer out the first 3 quests in the, you know, roughly 15 minutes if I quit lollygagging so much. Maybe the first 2 quests. It'll probably be the first 2 because I'm probably going to go further in because these quests are actually really good for collectibles. That's one thing if you, again, pimping my blog. If you go on my blog and read the newbie starter guide, I give a list of things that you can sell on the auction house to make money early in the game. These quests have a ton of spawn points for fragrant drowsehood mushrooms, which you can sell for like 10 or 20,000 platinum a piece on the auction house. So we won't be doing that on this character, obviously. I will probably be just throwing them. Hey, we got a rare spawn here too. That's why I came over here, because I knew this jackass could spawn in here. Didn't think he actually did though. That worked out for him. Sweet. Loots. What do we got? More useless stuff, I'm sure. A devoted dwarven axe of stunning. I love it. That's something that everybody is still bitching about, the fact that everything has caster properties on it. But it's, again, it's something that I think once they release the... Oh, lily petal. These things are really just trash. I wouldn't recommend ever looting them. You can trade their components into a trader in this area somewhere. I can't remember where he is. And he'll give you some potions for them, but it's really not worth the inventory space. And do I not have... Where's my collectibles bag? Of course my collectibles bag is full. That's just great. Here, let's get rid of this. All right, and that'll be fine. I just need one extra space for the fragrant drow's hoods to stack in. All right, here's Ungers with his minions.
The hobgoblins here do not seem hostile. In fact, their chief beckons you closer.
I wanna check my skill tree really quick and see. All right, so we're gonna be able to get Call Lightning next level, or next point, rather. Oh, that's exciting. I'm gonna move Fire Trap here. I don't remember whether or not Fire Trap was worth anything, and he's gonna give us some goodies because we found him, apparently, which is a undead... Well, it's a negative energy damage Kopesh. Oh my god, and the damn... Whatever.
Hey, you! You look like you could handle some hard work. Ever heard of Splinterskull?
Yes, I have. What about it?
Then you know Chief Yarkutch there is right wretch who could stand to shorten be shortened by head, I can't do that just yet, but I could use some help giving him some of his mischief right back. Interested?
Sure. What do you want me to do?
Just a little thing first. Get the Skuller's attention. Go in, kill a few of them, let's say 20, and come back and tell me how you did. May have some more work for you then, if you please me.
Alright, so this is our first quest. Go and just kill some things. Okay. So what items is he offering? A +2 alkaline 12 scale mail of Sonic Guard 1. That is a mouthful. I'm gonna stick with our robe because armor screws with my spell casting if I recall correctly. So what is worth the most? 807, 1200. Bam. Problem solved. But as I was saying, the revised crafting system, I think, is going to really make it a little better for making items that you might actually want. They do have it set so that, what we got is probably like a totem or something. Yeah, Blade of the Dark Six, not worth anything. The way they're doing it is there are certain affixes you can only find on random gear and certain affixes you can only find on crafted gear, which I actually think is a good idea. Because you can make stuff that everybody's going to want to have on crafted gear and then make rare cool stuff on random gear. I think that's like a clever way to go about things. So like, you know, saving throw bonuses, for example. You want, like, everybody wants saving throw bonuses, so you make that so it's craftable. The only thing I don't like about the saving throw bonuses they did is that they made it so that, it's not universal anymore. In pen and paper, if you had an item that granted you a bonus to saving throws, it just granted you a bonus to all saving throws. Whereas now, that is not the case. You find, like, on random items, plus fortitude, plus will, plus reflex. And I'm sure that's intentional, too. But the downside is... Oh, that's right, on this... Maybe I'm brain farting. I think it might be on this first mission. There's only one of these mushrooms back here, but normally I think there's two. Along with some oozes, which are no threat. All right, so we grab the mushroom, and we got a flowering hell's cap, which is worthless. Taking up space in here, whatever, I'll deal with it later. Anyways, it's kind of a pain in the ass that way, but they're not touching old named items, and they've specifically said that they are using named items as an excuse to basically make items with properties that you wouldn't be able to find them on rare or like random generated stuff, which they've got a list somewhere on the forums of what properties can generate on what items. Like, for example, Constitution. I'm just pulling this out of my ass, so don't take it as accurate or anything. But Constitution, for example, might only be able to be found on belts. Well, with a named item, you might be able to find Constitution on a necklace. And it's stuff like that. I think it's kind of a good way to keep named items valuable, because a lot of people are whinging about the fact that named items are kinda less awesome now. Come on, yippers. Don't make me expend more mana than I already have on you. I gotta remember, what are my buffs? I got Bark Skin, Long Strider. Man, I should... Yeah, we'll We'll kick these guys up. Look at that 22-minute long strider. Everybody's jealous about my stride. Wow, we look doofy with that bar. We are a wooden dog. This is another thing you want to loot, the bookshelf, because on that you can find a silver flame hymnal, which, again, is worth, I would say, probably between, I don't know, 10 and 20,000 platinum.
There must be levers to control it nearby.
The levers. Those fiendish levers. Okay. Hey guys, I'm wood. Oh, I'm tripped. I need AoEs so bad. That is one thing that I do need to do is actually figure out what feats I'm going to get and stuff, because like this, the complete and utter lack of AoEs is just painful to me. Come on, yippers. Get you back up to snuff. Wasting all my spell points healing you. Alright, well, Potion of Cat's Grace. Some bonus dex, which I don't think will really, well, that'll do something for me. But it's not worth drinking, because we have 10 more to kill, and, you know, it's not exactly a ton of things here. Death to the Dargle lovers? Yes, Dargle lovers. General chat to the rescue, as I circle strafe my way to victory, with circle kicks and violence. Here, I'm just gonna lay a fire trap for you guys. I'm casting it, I promise, it'll happen. There it is. On fire trap. Yeah! God damn, that thing does a lot of damage. Alright. Fire trap can stick around. Like, if for nothing else, because it's my only friggin' AoE. Empowered maximized. How many spell points does that thing send me back? 48. Ouch. Alright. I need to get Quicken on there, too. That would be something that would be much more useful with Quicken on it, because I'd be able to just instantly drop it in the center of a group. Of course, it'd be costing me like 60 spell points, but. I mean, if it's 60 spell points and it kills six things, that's not too bad. I'm gonna cast some healing on myself here. You jerks can just all burn or freeze, as the case may be. So this is gonna be 1,200 experience points, which, looking at things, might actually, after modifiers, be enough to level us. Well, rank us up, I should say. All right, we need one more. So I know if we go down that way, there are more mushrooms we could get, but I think it might be a... We could do it, but it's not going to be worth it at this point. I don't even know if they spawn them in this first quest. I know they do in further ones. Hey there, buddy. Chill out. There we go. 1,500. Ugh. Ugh. 500 experience points away. That's okay. We'll get it on the next one. So we're just going to go ahead and finish it out and see what kind of goodies we get. This quest line, it used to be really great to run for stat boosting items, because when you finish this entire chain, you get chain end rewards.
The Hobgoblins here do not seem hostile. In fact, their chief beckons you closer.
You get chain end rewards, and this used to be, I think, the only place in the game where you could find +3 stat boosts on gear this early. Like, they were underleveled +3 to your stats. But they're obviously worth a lot less now, considering all of the modifications they've made. Anyways,
not bad. Not bad at all. Of course, any warrior with a salt could have done what you did, but at least you're no weakling. Yarkutch will be mighty angry, too. Can almost hear him whining about the men he lost.
Huh. You have any more work for me?
Aye, it so happens I do. Words come to me that his men have been snatching people from Stormreach's streets to give the Dargwill a bad name in the city. Go get them out. I'll tell the tale back in the Reach, and the coin lords will find out the Dargul aren't to blame. Ungers grins slyly. Not this time, anyway.
Alright. We might actually rank up off of this Slayer. 415? It's gonna be close. Because, yeah, this is another thing, is you build up your Slayer, because every time you run in and out, you kill like 5 of these guys. Wow, that Nimbus of Light really saved you, buddy. Yep, there's our rank. Sweet. I'm gonna kill you. I don't remember whether or not we can actually spend points out here. No, we cannot. I'm dejected. Shit.
I found the mouth of Splinterskull.
In we go. Yeah, I know. You've said it before. Obviously, the downside to this quest line is it's all the way out here. So between episodes of me recording, I'm gonna have to finish out to the tavern. And I will just run my happy ass back here every time. So the Slayer will kind of scale up and we might get some experience and stuff off screen. But you guys aren't going to be missing anything. Kill these suckers. Literally, they're spiders. That's how they eat. Ha ha. Terrible, terrible humor. I think Barkskin's getting a defense. Maybe not. Maybe there is just one of these guys back here. Bruce Sporepod. Disappointment strikes again. These guys. Just obnoxious. Okay, but anyways, you do want to come back here and grab that, because I can, you know, it has a chance to drop something that's worth like 20,000 platinum. You want to come back and grab that every time. Ideally, you want to hit all of them. There are, I want to say, 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 in this quest. 4 of those, and then the one bookshelf, and I think there are 2, like alchemy tables that you can get some valuable stuff out of too. You can get like luminescent dusts. And if you're really, really lucky, lightning split swords. I think all of the lightning split swords I've ever found, I found in this quest chain. And just a couple weeks ago, well, I don't want to say a couple weeks ago, it was the last time I played, right before I finished, I had a couple of them and I've been banking them for, you know, Lord knows how long. And I think 2, and you need 3 for the recipe. Ah, and there's a Silver Flame Hymnal, so that's 15,000 gold pieces, or platinum pieces, plus right there. Easy drop. They're not uncommon. They're not common, but they're not, you know, stupidly rare. You should expect to get maybe 1 or 2, like, per trip through the chain. But, anyways, I sold, I think, it was either 2 or 3 Lightning Split Swordwoods. I sold it for the most that the auction house would let me sell it for, which was, it's like 2 million platinum and some change. And it's like, it sold within hours of me posting it. The auction house isn't as fast as it is in something like WoW. If you throw something with max value on there. This game is, I don't want to say dead, but the population is much lower than something like World of Warcraft. So, you know, it takes a while, but it'll sell. Especially stuff for the rituals. Basically everything I linked on my blog, just, it'll sell. You might have to list it a couple times, but it will sell, and you can make a bunch of money that way. Because really, most people are plat capped. The platinum cap on your characters in this is like 2.4 million, I think, platinum. And the reason for it is because there's really not any meaningful gold sinks in the game. So, It used to be that the gold went to people selling tomes on the auction house, because you could sell, you know, a constitution tome, for example. Like, even still, if you're lucky enough to see one up, a constitution tome will be like 1 million platinum. They don't sell them on there anymore because Turbine introduced the Astral Shard auction house, where you can basically sell game items for, I don't want to say real money currency, but it's a form of real money currency. It's not like Turbine points, which you use to buy account features, but it's stuff that you can use to, for example, buy a character respec, or you can buy upgrades to your guild house, your guild ship, and stuff like that. So in a way, you know, you can get a sub form, we'll say, of real money currency, which I don't really particularly have any opinion on it, because if you wait long enough, you know, you can find tomes and stuff on the auction house. I think every tome I have on my main character, I think he's got +2 across the board. I think every tome on him I bought on the auction house. I don't believe I found anything that he could use. I found a couple +1s, and they introduced the way tomes scale. It used to be you'd find a +1 tome, +2 tome, +3, +4, +5 tome. Then, in their infinite craftiness, they introduced tomes that are specific, that'll let you go from +1 to +2, or +3 to +4. But if you have a +1 tome on you already, you can't use a +3 to +4 to increase it to a +2 tome.
The prisoner.
That I think was kind of shitty of them. But whatever. Anyways, that prisoner told us that they heard something feeding other prisoners to the spiders. And there is a group of spiders down in there. that will in fact eat your face off, and I think there's actually a rare that can spawn down there, and he told us to kill the warden. Ah, thank Aladra. They were going to come for me next to feed those things in the pit. I've heard them throw people in. The screaming, the tearing. The prisoner falls silent, shuddering. It's all right, now get yourself out of here.
To safety.
So yeah. They're feeding them to spiders, guys. The spiders. See, I don't know. See, I don't know if we can enter in here. I think we can. Looks like we can. We can! Let's kill some spiders. I know you bastards are in here, where are you? Oh, it's scorpions. I could have sworn it was spiders. Unless there's a pit in the other room that's spiders. And I think there's actually a rare one, too. I think. I don't know. I might just be going senile. It wouldn't surprise me. Oh, we got... Hey, a skittish prisoner down here. Nice. On a chest. Ah, here we go. Scorpions, oh god, the crawling, scuttling, get them off me! Get them off! His bloodshot eyes dart about widely. You're not sure if he's seeing anything real. Easy now, you're safe. I'll get you out of here. Your voice seems to bring him closer to sanity. He shivers and coughs, not meeting your gaze. Wish that were true, but it's too late for me. Too late! Too late? Why? Scorpions stung me too many times. I'm dying. Feel it in my heart. But before I die, I must warn you. About what? Hiding down there in the dark. I started listening to the stones. Sounds like I'm mad from the venom, maybe I am, but I've heard a voice. Something lives down here beside the hobgoblins, something old and angry. Lives in a watery cave and it hates. Such hate in that voice. I'm glad I'll never meet its owner.
From the poison, the prisoner dies.
Darn. I'm looting your chest, prisoner. +3 light crossbow of assassinate too. See, like that's actually not a bad weapon, except I don't think you can assassinate with a crossbow. I don't know. Anyways, that thing that he mentions is an optional boss you can fight in here that is fairly tough. We'll probably give it a try, I think. Like I said, I'm fairly sure by the time we're done with this questline, we'll be 7th level. By the time we'd be able to face this optional boss, we'd be 7th level. So, I think at that point, we might be capable of actually facing it. And we'll have some extra spells then, too, because I'll have unlocked 4th level spells. Which I think will give me Ice Storm, which will be getting spammed like crazy, I think, because that's going to be some AoE damage. Although, it might screw us, too, because I believe Ice Storm has a movement affecting... malice to it, so I don't necessarily want to deal with that, but, you know, we'll make the best of it. Let's get this guy out of here. That's right, Yippers, you kill him. Alright, more screaming and tearing. Rip and tear, rip and tear. Chill out. You're dead.
The prisoner flees to safety.
Yeah. And then if you've got... If you got a rogue, I don't know if we're gonna be able to fight the ward or not. If you got a rogue, you can pick these locks, and there are storerooms that you can go into and smash the shit out of everything. And we actually are gonna fight the warden. If I recall correctly, he's an ogre, and he's like in this room over this way. Through this door! And I'll point out another thing that's gonna make me wish I was a rogue, because there's actually an optional chest you can
this
get.
Is the warden's
hey guys.
Room, where the prison's cruel
oh no, he's
torments his
just a hobgoblin. There's an ogre that spawns in here in later quests when we're running through here.
As he dies, two keys.
Oh, it's fire trap time, maybe. Maybe. Did I think I fucked it up. Poop. Oh, no, I didn't. I just didn't see it. Son of a bitch. That pisses me off. I could have killed like 3 of you dingbats. Instead, I gotta circle strafe around and be all crafty. Don't make me turn into a bear. Do flip kicks and shit. I got some tactics you guys don't even know. I know maneuvers. Come on, kill the infiltrator. Kill the infiltrator, there we go.
This key
grab the storeroom key.
Storeroom of some sort.
Yep. Hey there, buddy.
All the prisoners
you're safe.
Escaped from Splinterskull. Your work here is done for now.
Alright. So this actually will let us get into those areas that I mentioned requiring a rogue, but... See, I know there's traps. But I know there's also chests. And I am an absolute and unabashed whore for loot. Why do I still have these festival twigs? What is that? A singed sorrowed disappointment. Alas, not lightning split. Lightning split is what we're looking for. So can I get in here? Yes, cool.
There are many weapon breaks.
Normally I rogue my way in here.
It would be a blow to the hobgoblins if they were destroyed.
Yeah. I just want your... Now we can actually wear this because it's leather. Plus 8 armor bonus too, and some But we'd be losing some constitution, but this gives us electric spell power, which will be great for once we have call lightning. And I was gonna say, yeah, and I believe I have our outfit set to cosmetics. So I'm gonna hold on to this because once we have call lightning, that's gonna be, I think, a legit upgrade. And I think we'll actually pick up some AC from that too. I can go ahead and throw it on now. Well, no, I won't, because like I said, we're gonna be losing some constitution. What that means is that I'm probably just going to hold on to it until I find an item that gives me constitution, and then we'll switch it on. Unless I've already got something on me that does, which I might. I have no idea. I wish they give you a quick way to check, like, just all of the properties that all of your gear gives you. I think that would be really nice. Just have like a little tab you can flip out or something. Constitution plus 2 from our robe, and that is it. Disappointment. And I'm going the long way around because that's how I roll, apparently. Now, I believe this way is trapped. This is the hallway. Yeah. Yeah, and then there's another chest up there. Screw your vases and your crates. You know what lives in crates? Snakes. And I don't like snakes.
The last of the weapon is destroyed. Splinterskull will be long recovering from this day.
See, get anything good in here? Nullified heavy wood. That's actually a shield we could use, although it's complete trash. But I actually, god damn it, it's complete trash, but it's better trash than what we have. And the only reason is because of the guards. We have Thorn Guard twice, I believe. And they don't stack, so we might as well equip that. Are we actually, yeah, we're getting 2 points of AC there. So I'm gonna go ahead and throw these like so. When we get higher level, I think I've probably mentioned this in the past. Uh-oh, what did I have there? What was my other, I had 2 scimitars. What is this? Oh, this is my body feeder, okay. That's another property that they're not bringing back, which makes me so damn sad. I love my body feeder weapons. That enchantment was made for scimitars and improved crit. Damn it. Anyways, when we get to higher levels, I'm probably going to be carrying 2 scepters because that will be an easy way for us to get spellcasting stat modifiers, which we'll need.
In fact, their chief
yes, I know.
Brings you closer.
Ha! Those wretched scholars must be angry enough to spit knives now their prisoners are gone, and I've got you to thank for it. The Dargo will be off the hook with the Coin Lord soon enough.
Good, what next?
I know how Yarkech thinks. He wants to bring the fight to me next, so we've got to hit him hard again before he can. He's got 3 tacticians at Splinterskull. Kill them and take their documents, and watch out for Blood Drinker. He's a mean cuss of a spider Yarkech keeps his guard. He'll probably have loosed him by now.
Alright, so that is our next quest, and we are going to go ahead and recall, because I want to spend this point and get us call lightning, and I really am going to, I'm going to test it too. I want to see how it does, because, you know, I want to see just how obscene the damage this thing is capable of putting out. It's only going to get better, I think it scales, doesn't it, does it scale, what is it, how does it scale, spell point just go down, just the spell point cost, yeah, boo, that's okay. Oh, I'm excited. Call lightning. Let's see, chosen target. All right, so that's, again, single target, which less exciting. See, what's our top tier here? Word of Balance. Word of Balance is something that is really powerful in pen and paper, but is probably not going to be so great here. In pen and paper, it's great because you can shore your caster level up to be absolutely asinine, and it basically will one-shot things without a save, which, you know, is bullshit, but the game allows it, so it's balanced, right, guys? All right, so... Oh, I see you! Make yourself visible to me! No! Yippers! Yippers, quit! Yippers, be gone. You're a bro, Yippers, and you're doing what I normally want you to do. But Daddy needs to electrocute the shit out of something so that he can see how much his damage is. Give me, like, a hobgoblin or something. Here, where is it? I think... Where is it? Where are we? I think the giant spawns like up above there. He spawns in like a little island. What the hell? Oh, wargs. All right, close enough. Wow! 212 for 10 spell points. It's gonna be going down to 6. So that's, wow. That is potent, and that is only gonna get so much nastier as we gain levels, because I think it's a D10 per level. Yeah, up to 15. Jesus Christ. Oh, that's nice, I like it. Anyways, we are at 40 minutes. I went a little over, whatever. I'm gonna call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time. Until then.